Hello, Power BI community. Welcome to the Power BI March 2023 update. Got a lot of exciting features for you this month. We're going to be highlighting a few of them in reporting and service. If you want to hear all about the other features that were released this month, find out more information on our demos, technical documentation, that sort of thing, you can find a link to the Power BI blog post in the description for this video. Let's get started. First up is on-object interaction. This new feature allows you to right-click on a visual to access the format pane. Roseanne will walk you through a quick demo.
I'll begin by creating a visual. As I add data to this visual, you'll notice that the visual type automatically updates based on the data that I'm working with. I can use the Build menu to quickly swap out the data that I've already added to the visual. I can also choose to change the visual type that's being suggested to me by using the full visualizations gallery. When I explicitly choose a different visual type, it turns off the suggestions so that I can now see all of the field wells expanded. Once I'm all set with the data that's in my visual, I can go ahead and move on to formatting. Now I'm using the Add button to quickly add a few chart elements to my line chart. And you'll notice here, when I add the trend line, it's also just another chart element that I can add to my visual. Now remember, the existing hover and click behavior for a visual is to show a tooltip and cross-highlighting and cross-filtering. But once I double-click on the visual, I now enter format mode, which automatically opens the format pane for me and changes the visual container to be blue, so that I now can see sub-selections instead on hover and click. I'm going to make a few changes here, such as changing this line color. Oh look, Power BI thinks I'm trying to click on the marker. So let me go ahead and flip that to the line and change the color. Now I want to edit my title, so I double click and go ahead and type in my new title. I exit the direct text edit mode to be able to continue formatting my title, such as adding a background color, adding a different text color, and aligning. And there you go. I was able to create, edit, and format that visual a lot quicker on object than I would have been able to do using the panes as before.
As a reminder, this new feature is in public preview and must be turned on in the Options and Settings pane. Next up are updates to the way you can apply slicers on your reports. The Apply All Slicers button is a new feature that allows you to make slicer selections and have the report visuals only update once you've finished making all slicer selections. You can also add in the Clear All Slicers button to easily remove any selected slicers. Let's look at Zoe's demo to see it in action.
When we released the public preview of the optimized ribbon with paused visuals for authoring reports, feedback we received was for a way to allow your report consumers to make slicer selections and have the report visuals only update when they're finished. The wait is now over. We're happy to announce the availability of the Apply All Slices button. When the Apply All Slices button is on your report page, you can make multiple selections across all the slices on your report page and then simply apply them when you're done. Each slicer will indicate that it has a pending change, and then when you're ready, you can click the Apply All Slices button to apply them. Another popular request was to have a way to clear all your slices selections at once. So we added also the Clear All Slices button. And when you click on that, all the slices selections are cleared and applied at once. You can add in as many of these buttons as you like, and you can add the Apply All Slices button from the Optimize ribbon, or you can go to Insert button, add either the Apply All Slices or the Clear All Slices button, or in any existing button, you can change the action to be Apply All or Clear All. Now in your report, if you have hidden the Apply All Slicers button, like with a bookmark, here I have this bookmark here where I've hidden the Apply All Slicers button. Now your report slicers will just act like before. So they will instantly apply as you make selections. And then finally, because the Apply All Slices button is a better query reduction experience, the optimization presets is no longer going to add the single apply button for slicers when you choose the query reduction. Instead, it's going to recommend the Apply All Slices button, but it will not add it for you. And when you go to the options, the query reduction options, you will see we're also recommending the Apply All Slices button, but you can still use the single apply button on slices if you choose to. And any reports that are already using them will still continue to work just as they did before.
Let's look at multiple audiences. With multiple audiences, the Power BI app author can create multiple audience groups within the same app and design different permissions for each group. Michal will show you in a demo of this feature.
In this release, we are announcing that the Power BI Org App Multiple Audiences feature is now generally available. With this new update, the Multiple Audience feature is now supported by Power BI Mobile. In Power BI Mobile, as in service, app consumers can only view the content artifacts based on the access permissions for the respective audience groups. Users who have access to multiple audience groups will see them in the mobile app navigation tree. By default, users will see all content that they have permission to view, but they have the option to change and select a particular audience view. This can be done by tapping on Change and then selecting the desired audience, which will display the available artifact for that particular group. It is also possible to browse all different audiences using the app's content list. The audience group will be available in tabs with their relevant items.
Next, let's cover email subscriptions for scorecards. Subscriptions allow you to receive email notifications and stay up to date on the most important data for you and your team. ANSI will demo this for you.
Metric subscriptions enable you to receive email notifications and stay up to date on the scorecards that matter most to you and your team. To set up a subscription, select the Subscribe button in the ribbon. Then select Add New Subscription in the pane on the right side. Note that you can subscribe to scorecards if you have a Pro or PPU license, or if the scorecard is in a workspace backed by premium capacity. Enter the details about the subscription, such as the name for the subscription, the subject for the email, an optional message for the email, and select the frequency on how often you want to receive the email, such as hourly, daily, weekly, or monthly, and select a scheduled time for the emails and specify the time zone. Then select a start date and optionally an end date for these emails. You can include a link to the scorecard in the email and give recipients permission to view the scorecard using these checkboxes. Finally, select Save and Close. After saving, you can edit the subscription, turn it on and off, or delete the subscription using the same pane. You can see all the subscriptions that is set on this scorecard in this pane. And you can see all the subscriptions in that particular workspace by selecting Manage All Subscriptions at the bottom corner. Recipients will receive an email at a set time from Power BI with a table that contains the scorecard data, such as the metrics, names, status, values, and due date.
Finally, let's take a look at storytelling. We're pleased to announce that storytelling in Power BI is now generally available. This integration enables users to easily include interactive Power BI visuals in their PowerPoint presentations. Let's turn it over to Maya for a quick demonstration.
We are happy to announce the general availability of Power BI Storytelling Add-in for PowerPoint. Power BI Storytelling Add-in for PowerPoint helps you add data and insights to your presentations to drive data-driven conversations and decision-making. To add Power BI data to a slide, you can use this button in PowerPoint, or if you do not have the button in your PowerPoint version, you can go to the Office Add-in store and get it from there. Just search for Microsoft Power BI. Those of you who are already familiar with the add-in probably noticed the new banner at the bottom here. We added this to let you know what new features are added to the add-in. And clicking on the Learn More will open a features learning page to tell you more about the new feature. So you will never miss any new capability that can help you make stunning data-driven presentations. After you add the add-in to your slide, you need a URL from Power BI. You can get a URL to a report page or to a specific visual. The ability to embed only a visual and not an entire report page is new. Let me show you how to do it. By using the ellipsis menu on a visual or the right-click menu, I choose to share this visual. And then I can either select copy link to selection or open in PowerPoint and then copy the link generated for me. Now that I have the URL I need, I go back to the slide. Here I pass the link to the add-in to load my data. Now that my data is loaded, you can see that it is up to date, live and interactive. At the footer, there is the information about my data, a link to open the visual or the report in the browser, and actions that I can perform on my data. I can update the filter to make sure I see the data I need for this presentation, and then to hide the filter pane completely so my audience will be able to focus on the content itself. I will resize the add-in to make room for some text I want to add to the slide to explain the data I am presenting, helping me to point my audience to the data that requires their attention. But instead of me typing all those explanations manually, I now have a new feature to help me to be more productive. The new Data Insights action, which is powered by Power BI Smart Narrative Engine, generates data insights for me. I can then add those insights to my slides or copy them to my clipboard and use it whenever I need them. Power BI Storytelling Add-in is now generally available. That means that it is also available for users and organizations using national clouds. But since Office Add-in Store is not accessible from these clouds, administrators need first to get the add-in from Power BI Download Center, and then to use M365 Admin Center and centralized deployment in order to deploy the add-in to their users. You can read more about centralized deployments in Office documentations.
Well, that wraps up our feature highlights for this month. Tell us in the comments, what was your favorite feature? Was there another feature this month that you think should have made the spotlight instead? Tell us in the comments. We would love to hear about it. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.